In today's Community Corner, helping animals in need get a paw up in life. Back in 2005, Hurricane Katrina tore through New Orleans, leaving a path of destruction in its wake. Among those affected, hundreds of pets, including a cattle dog named Kate. Her amazing survival story is told in the touching book, Eight State, Hurricane Kate. And this morning, author Jenny Pavlovic is here to tell us more. Hi, Jenny.
Good morning.
You've brought with you a friend. Chase is watching. Ears are up. Very interested. Tell me a little bit about Chase, who's with you today. Because this is not Kate in the book. This is another one of your dogs.
But Chase's story is also told in the book. And he was rescued by my friend Sarah from Virginia, who I actually met in Louisiana rescuing animals after Hurricane Katrina. And Sarah rescued him from a man who was going to shoot him for chasing sheep.
Oh, because he was just wild running around.
Yeah, and I've adopted him now. He's my dog. And he's actually very talented at herding sheep when he has a little bit of direction.
Yeah. Well, and when you have the sheep. You have to have the sheep.
Exactly.
I had a herding dog, a Sheltie, and she herded kids, into little circles and groups. But a very sweet dog that now has a very nice home with you. There's a lot of territory to cover here. This book is amazing. Many, many heartfelt stories about dogs just like this one. Let's talk a little bit about how you came to meet Kate and to write this book. You work here in the Twin City area, and what's your regular day job?
I'm a biomedical engineer, and I worked for Guidant Corporation at that time, and they offered a week of paid time for anybody who wanted to go and volunteer and help after Hurricane Katrina.
And had you been, worked at a shelter, or why did you pick the dogs? You told me you were getting emails from a lot of people. What were they saying to you?
I was kind of wondering why everybody I knew was forwarding these emails to me, but I've taken care of animals all my life, and I've had dogs and cats and gerbils, and I had horses before, and they were begging for more volunteers to come down to help take care of the rescued animals because they had barns full of rescued animals but not enough people to do the labor.
Mm-hmm. So your friend said, you're the one, you go.
Why don't you go
on our behalf.
But then I couldn't find any one of them to go with me, so I ended up flying down by myself and meeting up with people who were already there.
What was it like when you got there? Because I know you were in Baton Rouge, which is, 30 miles away or so?
Yeah, 30 miles? 70 miles northwest of New Orleans.
Oh, okay. And that's where they had set up this shelter, if you will, in the expo center there. What was the scene like when you walked in?
It was at the Lamar Dixon Expo Center in Gonzales, which is near Baton Rouge. And it's a big outdoor, a big fairground setting. And they had outdoor barns that are usually set up with horse stalls. And they had a lot of those stalls modified and just full of dog crates, full of dogs. And when I arrived there, it was pouring down rain, and it was hot and humid, and during the time I was there, I think the heat index was 116 one day, so it was, it was really hard on the workers, and we had to pace ourselves, but I met people from all over the country who went down there to help, and I met the most amazing people there.
Well, Jenny and I both said that if we can get through this interview without crying once, we'll be doing pretty good because the stories are unbelievable. A lot of volunteers were leaving, too, because of this heat and the conditions. It was tough. It was sort of organized chaos because what was your job? You had to get the dogs in there. You had to check them, clean them. What'd you have to do?
They would go through an import process where they would be checked by a veterinarian, and they would have a bath and everything, and then they would be put in a crate in one of the aisles of the barn, and they had paperwork that came with them. And before during the week that I was there, they started shipping animals out to different shelters around the country that have volunteered to take them in.
Now, I'm going to jump in here because you had to leave because the next hurricane was coming.
Right.
And you put Kate in your car and took Kate with you. And we're so short on time here, but Kate turned into sort of a symbol. And tell me about her legacy now.
Well, the book, 50% of the profits from the book go to the Eight State Kate Fund to provide financial relief for animals in desperate situations. And this whole network of people came together to support Kate and me from all over the country, and even a woman from Australia, a woman from Canada. And now some of the profits from telling Kate's story go back to helping those people rescue other animals.
And we are going to tell people about how you can rescue some animals. The story is tremendous. Kate was found on a roof, right?
She was rescued from a rooftop, and she was rescued 9 days after Katrina, so we think she probably was there that whole time.
Yeah, so many great things. Okay, I'm going to tell people how they can meet you and get in on your event. Thank you. Thank you, Chase, for stopping by today. Jenny will be hosting a book event at the Minnesota Valley Humane Society's Mardi Gras Party for Animals this Saturday, February the 21st, at the Embassy Suites in Bloomington. The event starts at 6 p.m. and for tickets and more information, you can visit mvhspets.org and you can donate that way too. For more information on Jenny Pavlovic's 8-State Hurricane Kate and 8-State Kate Fund, visit showcaseminnesota.com, and we'll wrap things up right after this.